Looking for surgical precision in a speedy racquet? This is the Dunlop BioFibre M2.1. The BioFibre M2.1 updates the Biomimetic M2.0 and retains the same spec profile and technologies that gave this stick such an impressive combination of mobility and precision. With a 95 square inch head, this racquet is ideal for intermediate and advanced players looking for a predictable response. Offering a crisp, modern feel, the Dunlop BioFibre M2.1 is worth a serious look for players who crave control in a maneuverable package. I was on this playtest and the first thing that I noticed was the controlled response right off the bat. The 16 by 19 pattern paired with the 95 square inch frame really helped me get that control and precision that I like to have on the court. I did notice a bit of a lower powered response though compared to my RF97, but I didn't mind it too much because I was gaining so much more control than I'm used to. On serve, I felt I could just dial in my targets and really go after my spots and use this racquet as a weapon. At net, I did look for a little bit more stability. I found it a little unstable outside the sweet spot as well. But overall, the controlled precision, super maneuverable racquet was an awesome playtest. Next up, we have Chris, fresh back from the US Open. How was the playtest for you?
I really enjoyed this racquet. It's got a nice balance of control to it. The specs fall right in my wheelhouse, so it was an easy racquet for me to hit. The string pattern's different. I was a huge fan of the 1820 string pattern Dunlop used to carry in their 200 series of rackets. And then like the previous racquet, this one has that really firm, crisp response. And I've got to be honest, I'm more of a fan of the really old school, softer, more flexible Dunlops that we had back in the day with like M-fills, etc. So, and aerogels. This one is it's a stiffer beam. I didn't really get any extra power from it. But what I did like to do was string it much lower. And in the lower end of the string range, it opened up the sweet spot for me and I was getting more depth and pace in my shots, which was really nice out there on the court. Thought it was a good serve and volley racket. I agree with you. There was a little bit of instability up at net if you're off center, but the lower tension really helped me bring that around. So it was a good play test. I would just string this one low or use a really soft, lively poly or even hybrid just to open up that sweet spot a little bit.
Next up, we've got Mark Boone on this playtest. Now, you just mentioned you love previous versions of this racket. How did this one work out for you?
Yes, I stored away 3 4D versions with extra grommets in the catacombs. I keep them just for the day when I'm going to switch back to that racket. Lately, I've been playing with heavier rackets. I've kind of been fluctuating. This is hovering right around the 12-ounce mark, and this was a great playtest for me. Overall, stability was there for me. I know you lamented that maybe stability was not what it could be at net or whatever, but for me, the 12-ounce racket was just about perfect for me. The only thing that I noticed, interestingly enough, is it does have a 16-19 relative to the 18-20 of the prior. I had a little bit of a challenge keeping the ball high up over the net, keeping it out of your strike zone and other people's. I felt like my ball was landing flatter and a little shorter overall. But the frame itself, for anyone that's not looking to go way over the 12-ounce mark, like Michelle is here, but doesn't want to go to the modern player's frame type, it's a dynamite frame. Overall, I love the play test.
Next up, we have Granville. Now, Granville, we've been battling it on the singles court lately. How did this racket help you?
Well, it's been a real interesting test on a bunch of levels. One, gearing my current racket to this racket. And it's interesting. It has some very similar playing characteristics in that it's maneuverable, nice, soft, comfortable, sweet spot. I'd agree with what I'm hearing some of the other testers. I found myself on a court-to-court comparison. These balls were landing short in the net, so it was a relatively simple adjustment to raise that ball a couple feet over the net. And then once you get dialed in on the groundies, I can just crush this ball and feel real confident it's going to fall in the court. So overall, I really liked it on the ground strokes. At the net, again, nice headlight, maneuverable, comfortable feel. I don't think I'm going to get any extra power on the serves on this racket due to the, it has a 70 flex, but it just didn't really give me any extra power. But the control and the comfort is there. Liked it a lot.
For this playtest, we strung this racket with Black Widow, and we started at 55 pounds, but like Chris mentioned, we like that softer feel, so we dropped it to 52 pounds. For more information about this racket, please visit us at tenniswarehouse.com. Thanks for watching.